got people walking in the door, so we got a special this morning that we got for mothers, and I just want to welcome y'all. Happy Mother's Day! Before we get started, I would like to ask y'all to bow to you on this day with a word of prayer, and just to ask God to bless this day. Heavenly Father, Lord, we come to you today. Father, we just want to lift our moms up to you. We want to thank you for our moms. Father, we just want to pray that you just bless this day, just to be in our services as we glorify you, and that we give honor to those moms that you have put in our lives that have been that backbone for us. Father, that guidance in life. Father, that we just want to honor them in your name. Father, we ask these things in Christ's most precious name. Amen.
Amen.
Jesus, I'm the one.
your worship.
Rise.
have a seat. At this moment, I would like to ask our mommies, I know we have a lot of mothers here today, but I would like for our moms to come up front for me. I've got a little gift for each of y'all. So if you moms would, even if you're visitors, y'all come on up here to the front. Y'all just circle the stage here. Y'all go all the way around the stage. Yeah, you can stand up around the stage. Y'all take a step up. Awesome.
Thank you.
out is to the youngest mother. Who's the youngest mom here? Youngest. How old are you? 25. Is anybody younger than 25? Who? 25. You know, as we celebrate our moms, we know that everything that we can do for our moms is not just on a Mother's Day, but also throughout the year that our moms do so much for us. And my wife always says is that she has three kids, is that I'm the oldest of the three kids that she has to take care of. And I'm just a big kid myself and leave stuff laying around the house, and I can play all the time. And she's always getting on to me and Justin for throwing footballs into the ceiling fan. I told her I'm an electrician, so I can fix that ceiling fan. So she calls Dusty to get him to come fix the ceiling fan. But you know, growing up, moms play such an important role in our lives. And I guess one of the most important roles that they play in our lives is to show us how to love. Amen. You know, if it wasn't the love of our mothers, you know, dads teach strength and boldness and different things, but a mom, she teaches you how to have that compassion, how to have that love, how to love unconditionally. And there's some questions that moms always ask, and most of the time they ask these questions are in the midst of a bunch of friends hanging out together, and you know, when you ask your mom if you go spend the night somewhere, and she asks you if you're wearing clean underwear, because you never know when you're going to be in an accident.
Did you take extra socks?
When you ask if you could go do something, the mom always says, go ask your father.
Yes. Yep.
And then the dad says, I don't care, whatever your mom says. But a mom, man, they teach their children God's grace. Because a mom, the beauty of our mothers, the beautifulness of who they are and what they teach. And we're going to find that written in the book of Proverbs. And I know you've heard this passage of Scripture probably every Mother's Day, but as I was looking at this, there's some verses that we skip through a lot of times, and we go straight to the part where in verse 10 where it says, an excellent wife, who can find it? And a lot of times we skip those first 9 verses. And as I was studying and reading through these, as you see the same things being asked as these questions and these directions in life that a mom gives to her children. And a lot of times when your mom and children, y'all listen up real quickly here, is when your mom is giving you direction in life, it's not because they don't want you to go have fun. And that's what I always thought, is my mom was telling me I couldn't do something because she didn't want me to have fun. And she wanted to embarrass me. Are you wearing clean underwear? And you know, I'm like, come on, mom, you know I am. She's like, I know you. And so in Proverbs 31, if you get there, it says, and this is the words of the king, it says, the oracle that his mother taught him. And so we find out right off the bat is that he is giving instructions. This is what my mommy, this is what she has taught me. And I want you to pay attention to this, because he says, here's some instructions that my mom taught me, and I want you to hear these instructions too, because I've got one wise mom. And so this is where he starts. He says, my mom taught me this. What are you doing, my son? What are you doing, son of my womb? What are you doing, son of my vows? Do not give your strength to women, your ways to those who destroy kings. Man, when I read that verse, I was like, you know what? When a man gets married and his girl meets his mom, whoo, man, that is a battle. So, some of these men are like, yep, understood that, brother. Because when a man meets a woman, this is another woman's baby boy. That's her son. And she says, don't give your strength to a woman. What are you doing, my son? And you know, when I read that, this is where I get these, you know, where your mom says, you know, we keep going back, are you wearing clean underwear? Are you sure you know that girl? Are you sure you want to date her? I don't know if she's good enough for you. You know, when I first met Christy, I don't know that my mom did it on purpose. Where's my mom sitting back here? My wife hated to be called Christine. And her name is not Christine, but my mom always called her Christine. And Chris, after we would leave, Christy's like, I cannot stand when she calls me Christine. I'm like, I've told her 100 times. So I think my mom had to leave in her head. You're not good enough, my son, because your name is not Christine. But you know, he goes on and he says, it is not for kings to drink wine, or for rulers to take strong drink, lest they drink and forget what has been decreed, and pervert the rights of all afflicted. Give strong drink to the one who is perishing, and wine to those in bitter distress. You know, this is great instruction from your mother. She is telling you, you know what? You're a great man. You don't need to go and get drunk, because that people's going to like you the way you are. How many of y'all have heard this? Come on now. Your mom's giving you these instructions. She's telling you the ins and outs of life. She's telling you how to and what not to do. And so these are the instructions the king is giving back to these to us in the book of Proverbs, he's saying that this is what my mom told me to do. Then we get to verse 10. He says, an excellent wife, who can find her? You know, there's a lot of women. A lot of moms that have been mothers, even children that wasn't even theirs. I can remember growing up and going to my buddy's houses. I remember I used to have five or six different moms. And I knew if I went to their houses that I was always going to be fed, that they was always going to give me some kind of instructions, that was always going to love me. That's true, mom. You know, this morning as we are in this place right here, we've seen all of these women that surrounded our stage. We've seen all these mothers that come up here and their hearts, they have given time and time again for their children. And he says, who can find this excellent woman? Who can find this excellent wife, this excellent mother, this woman that has given her life for her children, that she would go to the uttermost parts of the world for her child? This is what he is talking about. This is the woman that you know, when Chrissy and I had Justin, Chrissy, when after Justin was born, Chrissy would get up in the morning, she would go to the hospital, and she would be at the hospital right by his side all day long. I would go to work, I would come home from work, I would go and change, and I would drive to the hospital, and we'd stay up there until 10 o'clock at night or 11 o'clock at night, and then we would go back home, and she would do that every single day for nearly 5 months. She was not going to leave her child, and the only reason she would leave at night is because they told her she had to leave. Moms, these mothers that have given everything to us, their children, and to those that aren't even their children. Those that have taken in these kids and taken them into their lives and taken them in and shown them a love that is unconditional. Who can find this excellent woman? She is far more precious than jewels. The heart of her husband trusts her, and he will have no lack of gain. She does him good and not harm all the days of her life. She seeks the wool and flax and works with willing hands. She is like the ships of the merchant. She brings her food from afar. She rises light as yet tonight and provides food for her family and portions for her maidens. She is considered. She considers a field and buys it with the fruit of her hands. She plants a vineyard. She dresses herself with strength and makes her arm strong. She perceives that her merchandise is profitable. Her lamp does not go out at night. She puts her hands to the staff and her hands hold to the spindle. She opens her hand to the poor and reaches out her hands to the needy. She is not afraid. She is not afraid. The greatness of our moms. When Jesus, at that moment that when he was crucified on the cross, before he said it is finished, before that he had that closing, is that I've come and done what my Father sent me to do. Guess who was on his mind? His mama. His mama. He tells his brother, take care of our mom. Take care. Because she's going to go through some hard times. Men, this is what I want you to take from this. If y'all all been there, you know your wife better than probably anybody else in this world knows your wife. But she has that face. Listen, you know what face I'm talking about. That face, you look at her, you say, what's wrong, honey? And she says, you know something's wrong. You say, okay, sweetie. My love. Tell me what's wrong. What does she say? Nothing. You know, I'm not the type of guy that just walks away from nothing. So I start,
oh, sweet, strong.
You know what? I make it all better 3 days later. I want to close this message with a point that's called my mom. And you know, we can say mom, we can say mother. But one of the first words that a mom wants to hear her child say, and I experienced this the other day with Hallie, and she was standing up on the stage and she was mumbling something, and Allie says, turns around, she says, "Mommy? Mommy? Mommy? Mommy?" That's right. We got mommy over here. So I found this poem. This is what really, Allie, what she was saying, this is what made me start looking at my mom. "My mom, your love, I know. I've seen your tears. You're giving to me my life. Walk through hours and days and years of heartache, toil, and strife to see that I could have the best that you could give to me. You gave up your needs and often rest, you viewed eternity. To do His will, my highest call, and by your special care, I stood and walked and did not fall. You helped me up in prayer, though stands of grace may brush your hair, and miles divide our way. I know that by your quiet prayer, you helped me day by day. You've shown me how to give, to share, to put my own needs last. You've helped me to see and be aware that life is soon to pass. To spite your love, I would not dare, for there's not another who spreads her gentle love and care like you, my loving mama." And so, as we close this day, I want to say to our mommies, in Proverbs 31:30, it says, "A woman who fears the Lord is to be praised." We praise God for those mothers who have worshipped and adored the Lord, who passes this legacy on to her children. We thank you for your love. We thank you that you're in this place to worship God and that you've given your life to raise great children that we have here today. I'm asking you to bow your heads. We're going to pray for our moms. And as we dismiss, before you walk out of this place, tell them, go and tell the moms how much you love them and thank them for what they give to our church and to their children. Heavenly Father, Lord, we thank you. Father, we thank you for our moms, our wives, that the fear that they have for you, that they praise you, they honor you, they give their lives just to teach their children how to love you and how to love our others. Father, I just ask you that as we leave this place that you would give us a guidance. Father, that you would go with us and you would keep us safe. Father, that you would give us a way that we just make this day special for our moms. Father, I just ask you that with your love that we would know how to love. With your strength, we would have strength for one another. Father, that through everything that we do, Lord, that we would give you the honor, the glory, and the praise. Father, we pray that you bless our moms today. Father, just give them a peace that passes all understanding, a joy that only you can give through your salvation. Father, as these moms are seated around us, Father, we just want you to bless them for who they are. They're yours. For it's in Christ's name we pray. Amen. All right, before you get up, before you do anything, I want to do this. On the count of three, I want you to turn to your mom or turn to your wife, and I want you to say, "You are blessed." Okay, on the count of three, I want to do this. Are you ready? One, two, three. You are blessed. Amen. Happy Mother's Day.